In this video, I'll help you automate inefficient work. The requirement is like this. I get data as a report from some system. Every day or week, that system sends me a mail. In the mail, there is an attachment with an Excel file. In the Excel file, there's a comprehensive report across entities. In real life, that entity could mean a person, department, company, supplier, distributor, anything. And I'm responsible for sending each entity their data. I'm going to filter on one entity, copy this, create a new mail, paste it, find out the email for that entity, and send the mail. That's one iteration. Like that, I'm going to repeat the process for each entity manually. We are going to use Power Automate to eliminate all this repetitive manual work. The sample file I have included, you can follow along if you like. The link is in the description. Power Automate is a part of Office 365, so that's all you need. So we are going to see how to automate the process by getting the data, going through each entity, filtering the table, creating the email and sending it. And then we will see on a day-to-day basis, how do you use that automation? So let's start in the beginning. Start with the data we have. It comes to you as an email. Now, as a part of this process, I am not automating detaching the email and automatically sending it, because very often the data comes to you in the wrong format. It is never a table, so we have to save the file first. Make sure the data is selected and you insert a table. When you insert a table, you have to give it a name. By default, you will get table 1 as the name. Next, we need a list of all the entities and their email IDs. Now, this is something you have to do one time. First column, entity name. Second column, email IDs. If you want to put multiple email IDs, separate them with semicolon. To create this table, you will need a list of entities. Probably you already have that. If you don't have it, just use the unique function. Table 1, square bracket gives you a list of items, entity, square bracket complete, bracket complete. Then copy that list somewhere else and then add the email column. This table is table 2. This table is table 1. For demo purpose, they're in the same file. They need not be. Ideally, they should not be, because this list is not changing often. Now let's import this data as lists. Let's start with the email list. New list from Excel. We have the file here. It will allow you to choose the table. There is a data type of type title, because in a list, the title column is always mandatory. It is text type of column. Name of the entity itself is text, so title maps to that. And then we have email ID, which is also text. Click next, give it a name. Let's call it email data and create. Notice I'm creating the list under my list. So our list is ready. Here, if you want to change the name, open the drop down, column settings, rename. I renamed it to entity. Now let's import the report data. New list. From Excel, this time we will use table 1, but here we have more columns. This is a date time type of column. This single line, a number, and then some decimals. Click on next. I'm going to call it report data and import the list. Again, I'll rename the title column as entity. Now you can make some changes here. For example, here I don't want the date time. I only want the date. So go to column setting, edit the column and say don't include time. So that's it. We have prepared the data. Now let's automate the process. To start Power Automate, click on this app launcher or those 9 dots waffle and click on Power Automate. You may see the Copilot functionality, which is great, but in order to use Copilot properly, you still need to learn Power Automate. I'm going to start from scratch and assume you have not used Power Automate before. So in Power Automate, we go to create. Here we use instant cloud flow. Instant means I will trigger the flow when my data is ready. So that's called manually trigger a flow. So when you click the button saying send emails now, this is going to come up. The first step in the process is to get our email data, because this is the one which has the list of all entities. This is a list and it's called SharePoint list. So we'll add a step or an action. We want to get all the items from a list. So open SharePoint, see more. We will choose the get items action from SharePoint. We need to give the site address. Go to your list, copy the web address, paste it, and keep it only up to your email name. Delete the rest of it. Then open this drop down. It'll show you available lists. And in this case, we are going to choose email data. Whenever we create a step in Power Automate, it's a good idea to give it a better name. So I've given a more detailed name. Now what we want to do is, in this list, we're going to go one by one, then go to our data and filter it. So whatever happens, if we get 5 items in it, we have to do repeat of that process 5 times. So that looping is called an action called apply to each. I'm going to say add an action. Under control, you will see apply to each. And now all the further actions we are going to insert inside this. Now apply to each what is the thing which it is asking. Select an output from previous step. You click on this button. So it'll show you a list of all the steps which have already happened and what kind of data they are offering. So we want whatever came from the list of entities and emails. Fair enough. So now whatever is happening here is for a currently selected entity. Next action, we want to get the data for that entity from our report data list. So this one is also a get items action. But before we do anything else, let's give it a name. I'm going to give the site URL and choose report data as the list name. But in this case, we don't want all the data. We want data only for the current entity. We need to filter it. So we give a filter query. In our data, the column name is entity, and we have to use a specific syntax. EQ means equal to, and in single quotes, we have to give the actual value of the entity which we are currently looping through. Now that is going to change all the time. So I'm not going to hard code it as A or BB. I'm going to put it as whatever came in this step, apply to each step. So we want to pick up the who, correct? And then complete the single quotes. Initially, it sounds a little confusing, but you will get used to it. Now, in case you get a for each added, just drag it out and get rid of it. Now, this data cannot directly go into an email. We have to convert it to a table, HTML table, because emails go as HTML. So the next step is a data operation called create HTML table. Now HTML table needs the data, and that data we have here in this step. So we open this and say whatever has come from filtered data for current entity, that's what we want. The next step is to specify all the columns you need. Don't use automatic because it'll put some additional columns which have some weird technical data in it. We don't want that. So show all, change to custom. And now we have to give the title for the column and the actual value. The values are going to come from our table. So I'm going to choose not ID. We don't need the ID. We don't want the entity column at all because it's filtered data going only for that entity. I'm going to start with date and give it a name here. Yes, if there are too many columns, this you have to do repeatedly, but there is no shortcut for this. Anything you do in Power Automate, keep saving repeatedly. Before you save for the first time, look at the name. It's a very long name. I'm going to change it data to email and then click on the save button. Save may not always succeed. There may be some errors. You correct them and then move on. Now, even though we have not finished it, let me also tell you how to test it. I'm going to click on the test button. Save manually. Test it. First time it is going to sign in into all the required things. Continue. Run. Now it will show you what is called as a run page. So for every step it will tell you this is done. This is done. This is not done. Something went wrong. So now you go there and look at what is the problem. No dependent action succeeded. So this one failed. Why did it fail? Let's find out. So to troubleshoot, edit, find the problem and correct it. The mistake was here. Even though we have given the name entity to that column, internally it still uses the column name title. So I'm saying title equal to title. So match the entity name and filter the query. And now it has created HTML table. So when you test it, it went through all the entities. There were four of them. This is the fourth one I'm looking at. And when I look at the table, this table has only one row of data because for a DD, we had only one row in our report. So things are working fine so far. Now the next and the last step to add is to send an email. Add an action. Look for Outlook, but make sure it is Office 365 Outlook. You may not see send an email action by itself. Click on see more and then choose send an email, whatever is the latest version. Now in the email, we want to send it to someone. When we got the list of entities and emails, we specifically have the email column. Subject, report for, and let's put the entity name itself, which is coming from who. And then the most important part, we want to add the table itself. So this is just fixed text. And now we want to put the HTML table. HTML table was created in the earlier step, whatever is the output of that. And that's all there is to it. So let's save this and test how it works. While saving, you may see a warning saying there is no limiting condition and so on. So let's put a limiting condition. In this case, only when there is a name of entity mentioned, we want those rows. And the name of entity was originally called title. And title should not be empty, not equal to. NE means not equal to. Empty is single quote, single quote. Now let's save it. And let's test it manually. So this is how the output is. The intended people received separate mails with only their own data visible. We have functionally completed everything. Couple of minor improvements to be done. The obvious one being there is no grid. It's just a flat table. So let's solve that problem first. HTML requires additional instructions to put a border around it. In order to format the table, we have to use the older editor. Click on this new designer toggle, save and switch. So in the old editor, click on apply to each, click on send an email. And now you will see an editor like this. Make sure you are in the HTML view. You'll see some HTML already written here. Just go in the beginning, press enter and paste the content which I have given in the description. This part defines the way the table is formatted. Once it is done, click on save. Come back to new designer and test the flow again. And there you have it. Beautifully formatted table with data belonging only to that entity. Now what happens when more data comes tomorrow? All that you do is go to your list, select all the data, delete it. Then go to edit in grid view. Make sure you're in the first cell. Go back to your Excel. Select the data. Do not select the header. Only the data. Then copy. Come back to the list and paste. Now let's make our flow more resilient. When I have something defined as an entity in the email data, but I don't have any data for that entity. Currently, in such a case, you'll still get an email with just the header and no data. Ideally, we don't want an email to go at all. So how do we handle this? After we filter the data, we should check how many rows were returned. If there was nothing returned, then these two things should not happen at all. And that's done by adding another step. That's called a condition. So in the condition, we check what was returned here. And the way to do that is not just look at the body value. We have to do something extra. We have to go to the effects. There's a function called length. And in that, we check what was returned here. Click on add. And we want to see if this value is greater than 0, then we go ahead. So I'm going to copy this action and paste it inside here. Same thing for email. And now delete the unwanted ones. Now, because we made a copy, the word copy was added to these steps. I'm going to remove it. Now let's save it and test the flow. Now what I want to check here is in the fifth row where the data didn't exist, what happened to the condition? So expression result is false. And that's why HTML table was not created, email was not sent. If we go to the second row, then the condition was true and an HTML table was created for BB and then the mail was sent. Now one really last thing to be done. This get items action has a limit of 100 rows. If you expect more than 100 rows per entity, then you have to go to settings and say pagination and give a threshold which is more than whatever is the maximum number you expect. I'm going to put it as 1000, and that completes our flow. So to summarize, you're going to get the data in Excel. We are going to create lists out of that data. The email list we are going to make once, maintain it by adding and removing records as time progresses. After that, we are going to go to Power Automate, automate my flows. You will see this flow. And when your data is ready, you're just going to click on the run. That is the time data will be processed and mails will be sent. To know whether it ran properly, click on the link. Now you'll see 28-day run history and you should be able to see what exactly happened in the latest run. If you click on this link, it'll give you the test page where you can see exactly what happened. So here is the summary of our steps. Manually trigger a flow, get the list of emails, loop for each of them, get filtered data from our list, look at whether any row was returned. If yes, convert it to HTML table and then send a mail. So please share it with as many colleagues as you can so that they also save time and grow faster. So that's it for now. Thank you.